Yes, he would. Yes, he did. Yes, he did. Yes, he did. Big.
You don't worship the Lord.
Tired of y'all simple ass dudes, man. Because y'all can't get y'all way and challenge us with no matters. So you want to do some of the street thing and talk slick with your mouth. Listen, the Bible is first and foremost, but you ain't coming up against nobody out there. Now let's get back to the street. Tired of you flapping the spirit, man. Every time y'all can't challenge us with the wisdom, or we should slap them, we should jump them, we should beat them down. See that we stand up for the word of the Lord also. We stand up for what we believe in. And it's a righteous thing to defend yourself in the Bible. We're going to read that too. Read what you got, brother. Read. The second epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Thessalonians, chapter 1, verse 6.
God,
see, it is a righteous thing with God.
The Bible says it's a righteous thing with God. Come on.
To recompense tribulation.
To recompense tribulation, God.
To them that trouble
us, it is a righteous thing to recompense tribulation.
Here, you black and Hispanic men, that's how you are, man. You dudes always thinking you so tough. You get it in, but you only do that to your own people. When it comes to white men and other nations, y'all niggas just pumps and fat. See, y'all, these niggas got pink panties on. Let's get them together and let's go fight the Klan. Let's go fight the Klan. Then they ain't got no heart. Niggas is soft then. Then niggas is soft. Let's go get some neo-Nazis, son. You get it in, right, son? Let's go get some neo-Nazis. Nah, niggas is punks then. They scared then. See, that's a read what you got, brother. Read. See, it is a righteous thing with God.
The Bible says it's a righteous thing with God. God, to recompense tribulation to them that trouble. I'm into something. Listen, the men of the Lord was warriors, man. The men in the Bible were, give me St. John 2:13. The men in the Bible were warriors, man. They didn't just kowtow. You black Hispanic men, you know what it is with our people? You always want to come up against each other. But when it comes to, listen, we're going to see what you're going to do. All these thugs and all these dudes that get it in, we're going to see what you're going to do in martial law. Let's see what you're going to do since you get it in, son. You so tough, son. Niggas is about it, right? We're going to see what happened when a damn martial law come in your hood. Let's see how you get it in there. We are sick of you so-called wannabe thug black and Hispanic men. You niggas make us sick, man. We sick of you and we sick of you coming up against us when we trying to tell you to come together as a people. We telling you the word of God, but you want to fight us and hurt us. You see that, man? And then we stand up for ourselves. Oh, y'all preaching the Bible? Any man got a right to defend himself. Even Jesus Christ taught us that in the Bible. Read what you got, brother.
Read. The gospel according to St. John, chapter 2, verse 14.
Come on.
And found in the temple,
God,
those that sold oxen.
Christ found people in the temple that sold oxen,
God.
And sheep,
God. And doves.
And doves, God.
And the changers of money,
God. God.
And when he had made a scourge of small cords.
Come on.
He drove them all.
Listen, man, Christ took the scourge of small cords and he went in there and he whooped people up out of the temple. So there were times in the Bible where it called for physical violence to stand up to defend yourself and defend the word of God. God,
and he drove them all out of the temple.